Landing on the moon in 1969 has been considered the most spectacular achievement by mankind in our quest to explore our solar system and the universe. But man is now ready to take another giant leap in space exploration by landing a man on an asteroid. This is no longer science fiction or the stuff of movies. It is really happening. NASA currently has a program that is not only exploring the possibility, but astronaut selection and a training program is already underway. NASA is planning to send humans far further than they have ever been before by making contact with an asteroid up to 3 million miles away by the end of the next decade. If the mission goes as planned, it would mark a milestone just as significant as Neil Armstrong's small step on the moon. To go to an asteroid, humans will have to venture for the first time into deep space, where the sun, not the Earth, is the main player. Asteroids are interesting on many levels. The primary goal is to learn about their hostile environments and the skills needed to work on their surface. Asteroids are also essentially an historical record of billions of years of our universe where we can take samples. NASA hopes that such asteroid missions will provide new scientific information about the early universe, while also providing valuable information for ways of defending the Earth from collisions with asteroids. Earlier, scientists identified an asteroid more than 460 feet wide that could come close enough to the Earth to collide with our planet in 2040. Such missions to asteroids could also help test technology needed for future human missions to other planets. Landing on an asteroid is the next step toward a manned landing on Mars. Landing on an asteroid, however, presents new and different challenges than landing on the moon did. For one thing, the moon is only 236,000 miles away and remains steady, orbiting around the Earth. An asteroid, on the other hand, can be much farther away, does not orbit the Earth, but orbits our Sun in what can be an extraordinarily large orbit. In addition, an asteroid wobbles and tumbles as it orbits. Added to that is the fact that asteroids have almost non-existent gravity to hold a spacecraft or astronaut on its surface. The spacecraft may have to hover around the asteroid, and the astronaut may have to spacewalk down to the surface. An astronaut could become disoriented on an asteroid, as it would be so small that when it rotates or tumbles, the sun would appear to spin rapidly across the sky, and the horizon would be only a few hundred yards long. NASA is developing special living quarters, radiation shields, and other new technology to allow astronauts to live in deep space for long periods. In zero gravity, bones start to lose their strength, similar to old age, at a rate of about 1% per month, and muscle tissue, including the heart, starts to waste away too. Also, when no longer shielded by the Earth's magnetic field, the body is exposed to cosmic rays which can damage DNA, which can result in tumors. Space radiation would raise the risk of cancer, and in extreme cases cause nausea and vomiting. Another effect is the formation of cataracts in the eyes, and for good measure, the central nervous system can be damaged too, with the brain being especially susceptible, leading to possible degenerative brain disease. Scientists need this kind of science if we are ever to send manned missions to other planets, and it is this kind of science that robots could not provide. By sending astronauts, scientists believe they would learn more about the psychological effects of long-term missions and the risks of working in deep space. It would also allow astronauts to test kits to convert subsurface ice into drinking water, breathable oxygen, and even hydrogen to top off rocket fuel. All of this would be invaluable before embarking on a 2-year expedition to Mars. This crew will be more on its own than any other crew in history. Once on the asteroid, the astronauts will need some combination of jetpacks, spikes, or nets so they could travel around the asteroid without floating off into space. They will also need some way to hold themselves down on the asteroid. We are still studying how strong the surfaces of asteroids are and whether they can even hold an astronaut in place. Otherwise, they would launch themselves into space every time they took a step. A manned mission will aim to rendezvous with an asteroid up to 3 million miles from the Earth, taking about a year to complete the entire round trip. The astronauts could stay on the asteroid for up to 30 days. While Apollo 11 took 8 days to go to the moon and back in 1969, a typical round-trip mission to a near-Earth asteroid would last about 200 days. And it would be riskier. Unlike the Apollo 13 mission, astronauts in trouble would not be days, but weeks or even months away from a return to the Earth. Because of the lack of gravity, traveling to asteroids will cost less fuel and money than going to the moon. Fuel for the return trip from an asteroid will be substantially less since there is no need to escape gravity from the asteroid. The idea that asteroids could be mined for resources has been around for years. Asteroids are leftovers from the early universe which did not coalesce into planets. Most of the remnants became the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. But some pieces were pushed out to roam the solar system. In the past few years, NASA and other space agencies have shifted their attention from the moon and other planets toward asteroids. NASA's Dawn spacecraft has revealed that around 6% of the meteorites that have hit the Earth had broken off of a large 120-mile-wide asteroid called Vesta, which was found to be high in metals and minerals, including iron and magnesium. Asteroids also have been found to contain such substances as hydrogen, carbon, iron, and platinum, which could be used by astronauts to make fuel and equipment. There are probably 1,500 asteroids that passed near Earth that would be good initial targets. It is estimated that about 10% of them contain water and other valuable minerals. Experts haven't chosen a particular asteroid for the deep space voyage yet, but there are a few dozen top candidates, most of which pass about 5 million miles of Earth. That is 20 times more distant than the Moon. Most of the top asteroid candidates are less than a quarter mile across. The Moon is about 2,160 miles across in diameter. An asteroid mission would be a Mars training ground, given the distance and alien locale. If humans can't make it to near-Earth objects, they can't make it to Mars. Such missions to asteroids will also help test technology needed for future human missions to other planets. So, landing on an asteroid is the next step necessary toward a human landing on Mars. With NASA in the process of identifying possible near-Earth asteroids to explore, and with the goal of visiting an asteroid by 2025, preparations are already underway. The plan is to send a robot explorer mission to the asteroid approximately 5 years before humans arrive, so NASA will need to make a final selection on which asteroid to explore within the next decade. NASA is planning to launch its OSIRIS-REx Explorer spacecraft to an asteroid in 2016. It will land on an asteroid designated 1999 RQ36 in 2018, after a 2-year voyage. 1999 RQ36 is thought to be a leftover from the formation of our solar system. The spacecraft will begin 6 months of comprehensive surface mapping while hovering within 3 miles above the asteroid. OSIRIS-REx will gradually move in closer and use a robotic arm to pluck samples from the asteroid and return to the Earth in 2023. Training, however, is already underway at a training facility off the coast of Florida called NEEMO, NASA Extreme Environment Mission Operation. The underwater capsule, called Aquarius, is a 43-foot long by 20-foot wide tube anchored in 65 feet of water. The Undersea Lab serves as a representation of the Deep Space Habitat, DSH, that will carry the crew over the long journey to and from the asteroid. Another multi-mission space exploration vehicle, SEV, will accompany the DSH on the journey to the asteroid and provide an exploration platform that will get in close to the asteroid and assist crew members during spacewalks. The NEEMO crew is testing whether their work is more efficient with different vehicles. Mission trainees also are determining whether they work better in pairs or on solo spacewalks. During training, each spacewalking crew member wears a thruster device to simulate the use of a jetpack. Training at NEEMO aims to help astronauts figure out how to move around on and collect samples from near-Earth asteroids with near-zero gravity. Since the technology for anchors to attach astronauts to an asteroid is still in development, NEEMO is evaluating different types of anchoring and how well astronauts work with them. The seafloor itself is being used to represent the surface of an asteroid. In some places, fiberglass rock walls stand in for harder surfaces. For part of the training, there is a 50-second one-way communications delay to simulate the average time delay astronauts will face while visiting a near-Earth object. The mission is hoping to use NASA's Orion spacecraft, which sits atop NASA's Space Launch System. The Orion spacecraft will be capable of carrying astronauts on diverse expeditions beyond Earth's orbit, ushering in a new era of human space exploration.